There's an argument that I sometimes hear that I'm going to have to kind of call BS on, and that is the idea that if you were not at a certain place, then you don't know what was going on there. This idea came about, I've heard it very many times, from someone that says, often it's been in friends that have been in the U.S. government's military, and they were at a particular place, and they say, well, you just don't know what it was like there. And they are absolutely right. I do not know what it's like. I do know the global picture as well as they do, and I think neither of us know the absolute truth. But from a global macro perspective, the fact that a person is in a place that something is happening does not give them necessarily the knowledge at a higher level. And so an example would be the Israeli-Palestine, the Arab versus Jew debate, argument, whatever it is that central banks want to have continue, because without that, it's tough to have wars. If you don't have wars, it's hard to get governments to borrow money. So it's a good income producer, and I'm not going to argue whether that's right or wrong, but the soldier that says all the Muslims are out to kill all the Christians, and I know because I was over in damn Blackistan or whatever, no, that doesn't tell you everything. Now, you have some perspectives that you've seen on the street. You have seen people shunning you. You have seen people offering you meals, whichever side, throwing rocks at you, blowing up your friends. You have seen some people from a place do that. And you have attended a lot of briefings, and you've received a lot of training about them and how them is out there to hurt us. And us are the good guys, and us is there to bring about peace or joy or freedom or liberty or women's rights or children's rights or whatever. And us is good, them is bad. And there's this whole us and them narrative that you and I have been taught our whole lives. First, second, third grade, high school, college, whole time we've been taught this narrative. We've been taught this narrative by the news. We've been taught it by schools, but if you went to government schools, you've been taught it there, probably your parents, probably your, if you were monotheistic, in United States, there are a lot of monotheists that are Christians, and there's a good chance your pastor passed along these ideas as well and supported them, and other organizations, 4-H, Boy Scouts, soccer, whatever, there are a lot of ideas that have just been pounded into our heads our whole lives. And it's not surprising that it's tough to let go of those and instead look for a truth that might not be quite as apparent. But it's our duty to look at things from a global standpoint and not believe what we were told, and then put what we were told together with a tiny bit of what we might have seen that was designed in that way, and then form an opinion that isn't really, truly, globally a big deal. Last night, we had a voluntaryist get-together at our house, and I'll tell you about four people that were sitting around the table. There were seven of us total. The guy on the far side is a devout Muslim. The guy right beside him was a Jew. The guy beside him was me, an atheist. The guy beside me was a devout Christian, another devout Christian on the other side of him, and then another agnostic atheist. And these are the people that are sitting around a table, and none of us are drawing our swords to cut each other's heads off. There have been a lot of people that have had wonderful experiences with people of different religions, different geographic areas, different government jurisdictions, different countries, and it is just unfair, it is not accurate to say that because I was part of a huge team that went to a place and invaded and killed a bunch of people and was told that those people are horrible, and then those people don't like me, therefore those people just hate all people like me and all the people do. No, that's not kind of really sort of how it goes. We have to examine things intellectually. So, no longer do I believe when someone says, oh, crime rate in New York is just, there's so much crime. Believe me, I lived there. You can get some ideas from living there, but you don't have to live there to know if there is a lot of crime or not. There are statistics that are obviously not all accurate. I know. But there are ways of looking at things and figuring it out without being boots on the ground. So I'll give you some credit for what you see, but don't claim intellectual superiority over me or knowledgeable superiority because you were actually there. No, that's not really how it works in honest thinking. Thank you so much for listening. I'd love to hear your feedback. Either send a private message or make a comment down below. And if you would, I would love it if you would subscribe right down there. Thank you.